One of the most important abilities of EUEM in helping you get to the bottom of performance and availability problems in your traffic is being able to read into the HTTP content of your traffic. In order to leverage this data to help you localize the cause of your problems, we make use of what we call custom fields. These are fields of data which we can use to filter traffic, as well as determine if specific values for these custom fields seem more problematic than others. Once we've defined a custom field, we then need to create what we call extraction rules to tell the system where to pull the data from to give us a value for this custom field for the hit in question, whether that be at the object, page, session, or primitive level. Technically, all fields of data in EUEM are custom fields, even the system custom fields, as denoted by the gear symbol, that the system must have defined in order to function properly. While these custom fields cannot be deleted, they can be modified and even broken if sufficient care is not taken when setting up their extraction rules. The first step is to determine at what level you wish to create this custom field. Object-level custom fields are used to identify objects. Page-level custom fields are used to identify page constructs and usually pull their information from the objects within these pages using the first, last, or all occurrences or the entry or exit points. Session-level custom fields operate in much the same way, but can pull their information from either the pages or the objects below them. There is a fourth type of custom field, and that is the primitive custom field. These exist only on our collectors, and their primary use is to delve into the hits and pull out information right out of the headers and even the HTTP content and store it. This hit-level data can then be leveraged at the object, page, and session levels by using the primitive custom field as a data source. Custom field data can be strings, integers, booleans, decimals, and IP addresses. When defining string custom fields, it is also necessary to limit the amount of characters to store for that value. The more data stored per hit, the less of them can be stored in the database, so it's important to keep such limits in check. Once we've defined our custom field, we then need to figure out where we're going to get the data to feed it. It's quite possible within your traffic, especially if you're monitoring multiple applications, that you may need to define different ways of extracting that information. This is why for every extraction rule we wish to define, beyond the default rule, we must define a filter to focus on the subset of traffic for which we wish to have that rule apply. Sometimes, all you need to do is to identify a subset of traffic defined by your filter, so instead of pulling data from the traffic, you might just have a fixed ring returned instead. Lastly, once we've defined what traffic we want to look at and where we want to pull the data from, we can also create transformations to turn the output into something more human-readable, or at least more meaningful to your organization. These can be used to trim, prefix, find and replace, etc., including string and IP mappings. This allows you to turn what might essentially be unintelligible code into clear information you can use in your investigation.